there's probably the ticket here is probably because there's probably been murder.
You can't say that.
Of course I can. The evidence is clear.
No, I mean, you can't say the reason is because. It's not good grammar. You can say the reason is that.
Oh, yeah.
And you used to mean probably is a sentence.
I probably did.
So, are you a detective?
Yeah.
Why did you pause?
Two reasons. First of all, I'm embarrassed to know what I really am.
And what are you?
I am a writer.
And why is that embarrassing?
Two reasons. First of all, you just drank a little bit about my grammar.
That was almost another reason to buzz. And the second reason you're embarrassed?
Because I'm a mystery writer.
The fourth one today. We have as many mystery writers here as we have murder victims.
I know.
And the other reason you paused when I asked if you were a detective.
I wanted you to think I was.
Why?
So you wouldn't suspect me of being a murderer.
Maybe I'm a murderer.
I doubt that. But I still might be a mystery.
Good line. You should use that sometime.
I just did.
I meant to say one of your books.
Why do you think I think something else?
Can you tell me this? Do you actually enjoy writing? I hate it. I've always hated it. Ever since I had to write stupid essays in high school.
Maybe if you were the smartest, then you would have enjoyed it more, and your teachers too.
Are you saying I would have enjoyed the essays more, or I would have enjoyed the teachers more? Or that the teachers would have enjoyed the essays more? The antecedent was clear.
I wasn't very good at that.
I thought you were a writer.
I guess my bad grammar makes for a good detective fiction, since I heard it's such a hard time solving the mystery when I was trying to say.
Well, thank you for the cup of coffee.
What about that other drink?
We'll have to wait and see if the book is still alive. I gotta get back to work.
Thought nice with the guests, I see.
You told me to find out about him.
I didn't expect you to get all cozy.
I was on break, and the gentleman was buying me a cup of coffee.
Have you figured out who Mr. Xerxes is yet?
Well, I found out he's not a detective, if that's what you're wondering.
How do you know?
He told me.
Oh, brilliant, Sherlock. Which reminds me, where are those little old lady mystery writers?
The client sisters. They sleep during the day.
Don't wake them up. I need to question them.
You can't do that. This is a hotel. We don't wake up guests.
They're not guests. It's pretty obvious they're detectives. Posing as mystery writers. Think I can be fooled by something as obvious as that?
Mr. Xerxes is a mystery writer, too.
Oh, this is rich.
And so is Marie Lamar.
I already knew about her. All those suspects.
As the murderer?
No, as the detective.
Will you quit it with trying to figure out if there's a detective in the resort? You should be more worried about finding a murderer.
There is no murderer. There's just somebody trying to find a murderer. Just to make you look bad.
I think you're doing a good job of that all on your own.
Do you want to see me?
Yes, did you fix everything?
I'm working on it. I did a lot more done if you didn't interrupt me.
Have you noticed anything suspicious? Like, people being suspicious?
No. But I've noticed some suspicious online. A lot of code violations.
When you get back to work. Want to see some detective work? I'll show you some detective work right now. So, Ms. Jones.
Yes?
I have some questions for you.
Questions? I don't want to answer the questions.
Doesn't matter. Let's start with your real name.
What?
What's your real name?
This is ridiculous. Just leave me alone.
Oh no, it won't be as easy as that. Just tell us who you are.
Us? You and Walt.
No more games, Jones. Just take off the shades and tell us who you are.
Don't you watch TV?
No.
She's a movie star. Well, on TV.
trying to let her say how much you enjoy staying here?
Talk to my publicist.
That could have gone badly.
Did you don't think that went badly?
Benwick, have you saw this from Officer Southerns? 47 years you've been coming here.
Yes, Raymond, they know. We all know. And they wish we'd gone somewhere else. And so do I.
They're going to make this up to us, Gingerbread. You hear that, Benwick? You're going to make this up to us.
Yes, of course.
Oh, sweetie, it's just wonderful. What a beautiful resort. How romantic.
Not bad at all.
Look, Raymond, newlyweds, just like us 47 years ago. Congratulations, you two.
Hello.
What a lovely dress. And what a cute couple. Aren't they cute, Raymond?
Yes, Gingerbread.
We made it here for 4 hours.
It only took us 3 hours to get here.
But we drove from Rockford, Illinois.
4 hours? You must have been going 90 miles an hour.
Average 92, actually. Skip Conway. That's Brenda.
Ray and Ginger Hetherington. How do you do?
Heathers and Chemicals?
Ramon.
Yes, Raymond started Heathers and Chemicals, but he sold it years ago. One of his worst mistakes. Isn't that right, Raymond? It's worth billions now.
Not now, Gingerbread.
But he made plenty of money selling granite eggs.
I used to have a granite egg.
How did you drive 90 miles an hour without being stopped?
I'm a highway patrolman. Drove in the cruiser with the lights whirling and the siren blasting the whole way.
My knight in shining armor. We would have ridden off into the sunset, but we beat the sunset by about 4 hours.
I'm just darling.
Pretty good.
Well, nice meeting you, Ranger, but we're gonna go check it out.
Of course.
The name is Father. Do you have a honeymoon suite?
No, wait. We have a honeymoon suite.
What?
Well, we don't have a honeymoon suite. We're supposed to. It's our anniversary, and we've come here for the last 47 years and stayed in the same room.
That's so sweet, sweetie. We should do that too.
But
Raymond had left the kids at the honeymoon suite.
Well, apparently they haven't, but we've had it every year for 47 years.
Well, we don't have it this year.
That's because they screwed up our reservations.
Hey, I feel bad about this.
It's not your fault, Mr. Conway.
Skip.
Skip. It's Benwick's fault. He needs to switch our room doors and somehow make it up to you.
Look. Mr. Hetherington, switching rooms with the Conways is not going to solve your problem. The Conways are not in the room that you want.
But they're in the honeymoon suite.
Yeah, we're in the honeymoon suite. There is no honeymoon suite.
What?
All the rooms in the resort are the same. But they're all very nice.
But you told us we were getting the honeymoon suite.
The honeymoon suite is just a regular room. But the package includes champagne, flowers, and little deli sandwiches.
Week.
The only problem is that we just gave that package to another guest.
Well, you've got another one, don't you?
Unfortunately, not at the moment. I could probably have him here by tomorrow, day after that, at the latest.
Why would you give our honeymoon package to someone else?
It had to be done. She's famous, though. Perhaps you've heard of her? Lavender Jones?
Lavender Jones?
Lavender Jones? Do you think we can meet her?
Sure, we want to meet her.
I can arrange that. Why don't you wait in the restaurant in the lobby? Miss Vinny, get that movie star down here. Get that movie star down here.
How am I going to do that? She wants to be left alone.
I don't know, maybe something else.
So friendly, who does have our rooms?
Well, I really depends. I apologize for that information because of the privacy.
47 years. Benwick, are you listening to me?
I'll tell you who has your room. A couple of detectives, that's who. All right, just who are you, really?
We don't like to tell people until the time.
Aha! You're detectives, aren't you?
What makes you think we're detectives?
You were just a little too anxious to get in here. Booked a room when the resort was full, and yet you were desperate to get a room. Paying a premium, and then, well, look at you.
What?
What? Come on, trench coats?
Oh, you saw the coats?
If you must know,
we sell trench coats!
What do you mean, usually? We never model them. We also sell umbrellas.
But why were you being so secretive?
Because we're waiting for it to start raining.
We know there's an unexpected weather front coming through. That's why we're getting in.
And you've got a room full of guests who will be raining.
tell a morbid joke right now.
Never
mind. You'll have to make two or three on the premises. We have enough problems around here today. Just add extra breadcrumbs or something. Oh, and tell me if anyone comes snooping around in the kitchen.
Well, there's something suspicious, like...
What?
Someone was messing with the spices.
How do you know?
They're all messing.
As I said, how would you know?
My cylinder's still missing.
No, just add extra sugar. Or sand.
Why are you bothering me again? I told you I wanted to go home.
Well, Miss Jones, we have a couple of your biggest fans here, and they're on their honeymoon. It would be such a treat for them if they could meet you.
I suppose.
Is Mrs. Conway? May I introduce you to Lavender Jones?
Wow! You're even more beautiful in real life! Brenda, here's the honeymoon suite. There's just a honeymoon package.
Well, there seems to be a dead body under the
Somebody. Mr. Yu, go find out who it is. Carl!
What do you want now?
Go help Mr. Yu. Ladies, why don't you enjoy a nice cup of tea in the restaurant? I'll make sure you get a discount. Maintenance man and actually fix something, your cover.
come out of it long.
So what do you know about poison?
Everything. That's why I'm on the case. I'm the only detective on the force who knows as much about poison as the villain can. Slow acting, fast acting, ingested, inhaled. Every poison is an overdose of something. Some things perfectly harmless in small doses. Some things, however, are lethal, even in the smallest doses.
How do you know you're an expert?
Well, I guess you don't.
What if someone is trying to kill us, baby? And I'm not hiding.
Don't worry, Brenda. We need something under control now.
I suppose it goes without saying that everybody here is a suspect.
There's only one way this could have happened.
One way? What?
Somebody called the police!
What are you talking about?
How did the police know to come here? How did the detective know to post the maintenance man? How did he even know we needed the maintenance man?
Then what are you talking about?
I'm trying to solve the mystery of why a detective showed up.
And I'm trying to solve a murder.
Yeah, we'll get to that. But first, I want to know who called the police. Was it you, Mr. Yu?
Are you accusing me of calling the police?
Yes, I am.
Well, I didn't, but I should have.
So you wanted to call the police?
I called the police.
You! I trusted you!
Mr. Fenwick, don't be such an idiot!
Yes, Fenwick, you're being an idiot.
That's it, Carl. You're fired! It's bad enough you coming here pretending to be a maintenance man. In fact, I bet your name isn't even Carl.
Right again, Fenwick. My name is not Carl. And if you'll shut up for just a minute, I will be able to explain a key piece of information that will narrow down our list of suspects. In fact, I will likely be able to make an arrest right now.
Oh. Well, do tell.
Thank you. Lunch and Gregor trying to have your first whodunit? Takes the modernist experience of work and practices on your weakness.
Huh?
Here.
This is great! We just caught the legendary Bell the Hammer. Cedar Manor Resort is going to be famous. People are going to flock here. They're going to want to stay in the rooms that were the scenes of the crimes. We might even get a few ghosts. This is going to be fantastic. What a lucky break. Corporate is going to love me. And here I was thinking I was having a bad day.
Corporate is not going to love you.
What are you talking about, Tinker? Go back to your vacation.
I'm actually not on vacation. I was doing a full assessment of the operations here and an appraisal of the property. And this place is a disaster.
What? Just because a few bodies piled up the last couple of days?
No, because you put so many corners on maintenance that the building is falling apart. And the cost of repairing it would be more than the resort is worth. We're going to demolish it. I'm heading back to corporate right now. Don't worry about my bill.
But I was having such a nice day.
Well, I came to write a gingerbread and that drink.
Wait, who's doing you? You can't drink on the job.
What job? Didn't we almost get fired?
We didn't necessarily get fired. They're just tearing the place down.
Mr. Redwood, let's all just have a drink. And as Mr. said, don't worry about the bill.
Miss Goodyear.
Yes, Mr. Hersey?
Can I ask you a serious question?
You mean may you ask me a serious question? Because I'm sure you can.
May I?
Yes, you may.
I realize that I need you in my life. Oops. And I must ask, would you consider becoming my editor?